Shall we sail then, you and I? Upon a glass still sea with no land in sight, with you in your boat and me in mine, waiting for the wind to take us where it wishes? I will send up flares and write you messages in bottles until we are reunited. If there are Vikings or sea monsters, we shall evade them, for we are clever and resourceful. Should there be tempests, we will ride them out on glorious waves. Or if the storms are too strong, we shall wash up on some distant shore together to drink from coconuts and tie seashells in our hair. When the storms have passed, we will sail once more, with you in your boat and me in mine. Get your ideas, people ask, as though they want the address of a store where they can buy ideas in bulk, wrapped in plastic for durability. With ideas and eye-catching lettering on the package and a 40% discount. But as far as I know, there is no such store. So the inquirers are always disappointed by my response. Get my ideas anywhere. They find me. They sneak in through windows and wait for me on street corners. They hide at the bottoms of teacups and in between glasses of wine. They harass me in the moments before sleep, curling up on my pillow like demanding cats and whispering in my ear. They grow like weeds in my head. And there is no escaping them. I chose this hotel because it has author-themed rooms, though which author you end up with is a matter of luck. To my delight, we end up in the Fitzgerald room. There's even a worn paperback of The Great Gatsby on the table by the bed, sitting next to a green glass lamp. I say something about the green light, and he just stares at me. "What are you talking about?" he asks, after the pause has gone on too long. "Gatsby," I say, holding up the book. "Isn't that one of those boring books they try to force you to read in high school?" he asks. It's more dismissal than question. He's already turned his attention to the rest of the room. "Boats against the current," I murmur to myself as he tries to figure out the buttons on the television. It is in this moment that I realize we're not going to last. Is an old birdhouse and some shiny stuff. You know, like glass and glitter or pieces of colored plastic or metal things that'll sparkle when the sun hits them. You can paint the birdhouse, but it doesn't really matter what color. It's not like how hummingbirds like red things. Fairies aren't that picky. So you take your birdhouse and shiny stuff and just hang it somewhere. High, but not too high. Trees are good, but fairies are everywhere, so trees aren't like a requirement. To put anything over the birdhouse entrance. Once they get in, they won't be able to figure out how to get out. Fairies are kind of stupid. Walk me home? Now? While there's still light? Before the afternoon turns to dusk? The light is fading quickly, so I'll need an answer soon. Would you walk me home along that line where autumn brushes against winter and golden leaves melt into evergreen? Where the sidewalk doesn't end? Where gloves do not require fingers to keep hands warm. And you may hold my hand if you would like. It is a quiet kind of walk in this light, at this time. I would appreciate the company.